Today, we are headed to Porsche of Fort Myers, who has graciously agreed to allow me to film tire mounting and balancing, and then also an alignment. These tires are about 5 years old, and they do have some tread left, but they're dry rotting. I realized that when I pulled them off to do the brake video. So anyway, stay tuned. We're almost to the dealer, and thanks for watching.
just telling you exactly where to put it.
Yep.
To the old one. Here, put them front to back and let's see if they're So we'll line up this side. There's great debate on which is fatter. I guess, yeah, from this angle, there we go. The Michelin is slightly fatter.
I use a tire frame and actually label each one, because if I put it from side to side, it'll throw off all your tire pressure sensors.
Oh, interesting. Grease?
Yeah, it's a grease pencil.
No, I mean the soap that you put on it. It's like, feels like lard almost, you know, like butter.
It almost does, but it actually dries.
Oh, okay, and then it just wipes right off.
Are we gonna put it through detail or no?
No.
I can get it wiped off then.
No, actually, I can, you don't even have to bother. I mean, I'm gonna wash the car.
Normally, if you just hit it with a pressure washer, it comes right off.
Yeah, that's what I've got.
shows
how far out and what needs to be adjusted.
Would that be considered good or bad? Or?
Red means bad. I've seen people track cars and camber up to -2. That, where the red's at right on those, honestly not too bad, but once I adjust those back into the green, it will knock the toe out completely. So adjusting the rear camber, the whole front, except for the caster, is going to get knocked out. So, explains why your tires were wearing the way they were.
Okay. So worth doing?
It is. I wouldn't really drive around with -2 unless you're on track, because at that point, instead of your wheels being like this,
yeah,
they're actually like that.
Okay. So you're getting a little more wear on the insides than the outsides?
Yes. Your front toe. Uh-huh. Right now, your steering wheel is faced straight. Your front toe. Actually, I can show you on the bar graphs. Easier.
Yeah.
So, your front toe is actually facing like this.
Okay.
And your back. See how it's almost in the middle?
Okay.
So if you haven't noticed while you're driving, with your toe being like that,
Your steering wheel is actually going to be pointed to the left just so you can keep the car going
straight.
Keep the car going straight? No, I haven't noticed, but... Good.
So your tie rod is actually right here.
Okay.
And there's a nut right back here. Adjust the actual inner tie rod to where it pushes the wheel
out
that way or in.
Got it.
after. Difference right off the bat is the tires are quieter. Just driving here this morning and now on my way back, it's the same road. I really noticed it during the test drive. Very, very quiet compared to the Pirellis. So I am happy about that. As far as feel, they feel the same. And of course, you know, I just love the way they look.
Speaking of looks, this is the final product. I've washed everything, but I haven't put any, you know, shiny stuff. Well, I guess I need to wash in there too. But anyway, I think they look amazing. Much more aggressive. And this is what I was talking about, this bead right here. So it's about, you know, it's a half inch. It hangs over the rim. It's the same in the front. And if you've had Pirellis, well, you get that in the front, but you don't in the back, and with the Michelins, you get it. And they actually add some thickness to the car. So if you look from the back, they actually look thicker. It's crazy. Very cool. Anyway, I'm real happy with the change. And as always, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe. I post new videos all the time. I think my next video will be bleeding the brakes on this car. So I'll walk you through that. One more peek at the front. All right. As always, thanks for watching. Please subscribe.